The forests, hills, and mountains of America speak of a nation restored. In 1932, the United States of America was gripped by economic disaster, unemployment, and a people looking for change. On July 1st, Franklin Delano Roosevelt accepted the presidential nomination. In an emergency session of Congress, Senate Bill 5.598 was passed by both houses and was signed on March 31st, 1933. This was the Emergency Conservation Work Act, better known as the Civilian Conservation Corps. 2 years later, there were over 2,650 camps and over 600,000 enlisted young men.
I went in the room and sat down. They were signing the papers, you know, and everything. And the lady says, "Aren't you gonna go?" I said, what's it all about? She said, "Well, these kids are headed north." He said, "They're gonna go into CCC camp." I said, "They are." I said, "Well, that's a good time for me to sign up too." I got a phone call. "Come to Birmingham, you're signed up, ready to go." So I found about over Fort McClellan, Alabama.
The men were involved in over 100 different types of work throughout the country.
You had trades. You learned a lot of things. How to use hand tools and improvement cutting, how to build head walls.
At 8 o'clock, you would line up and divide the guys up and foreman, a different foreman, Bill Long. You'd have maybe he would be on a gooseberry detail or something like that, or next guy would be on trails. We had different trails going. Then they were even after a bit, they started the survey too for different trails. We got $30 a month. We got a dollar a day, but out of the 30, 25 went home and we got five.
The speed and efficiency in which this program was mobilized was on a scale never seen during peacetime. The Civilian Conservation Corps restored and reshaped the landscape of the nation. The Corps built 97,000 miles of fire roads, planted over 3 billion trees, and renewed the confidence of the young men involved and the country.